Minkowski diagrams are a great way to visualize aspects of special relativity. The main idea is to use one axis as spatial coordinate, say x, and the other to denote time. Points in this diagram are called events. An event tells you where and when something happens. For instance, it's 6 o'clock in the morning and you wake up at home. You could either stay at home or go somewhere else. Let's stay at home. What happens an hour later? The houses surely haven't moved, and neither did you, so your movement is best represented by a straight line going up. This line is called your world line and is used to visualize motion in a Minkowski diagram. On the next day, 6 a.m., we decide to go somewhere. As time passes, we have moved from our initial position to here and later on to here. If we track our motion, we can draw a sloped line. So lines going straight up represent standing still, and the more they are tilted, the faster you go. Up until now, we have randomly fixed where to mark our axes. Let's fix this. In special relativity, one fundamental assumption is that the speed of light has the same value in all frames and is an upper limit to velocities. So we want to give the speed of light a special role in our Minkowski diagram. So far, the motion of light would look like this. Even if we considered very small amounts of time, light would travel extremely far. Instead, we choose the scale of our axis such that if we wait one tick of time, light travels one tick of space. This line describes the equation x equals t, which means nothing but x equals ct in natural units. One important aspect to notice is that nothing can move along a world line below the speed of light. Standing still, our world line goes straight up. Walking, running, even flying with a spaceship covers less distance than light would have traveled in the same time. Everything below the light's world line would travel faster than the speed of light, and according to Einstein, that's not possible. That's pretty much it for this time. Thanks for watching and see you next week.